Welcome to my YouTube channel F&B Classes, and in today's video we are going to discuss about menu. The menu can be defined as a list of the food and beverage items which can be served to the customers or the clients or to the guest through an catering establishment. And that catering establishment can be a very small one also, like a vending machine or a roadside kiosk. Or it may be a food truck also, it may be a fast food restaurant also, it can be a small restaurant or a fine dining restaurant. So in totality, menu can be defined as a list of food and beverage which are offered by a catering establishment or a F&B outlet to the guest. Now if we talk about the origin of the menu, we are not sure about when and from where the menu originated. In the history, we have a lot of incidents and the stories about the origin of the menu. And some of these stories which are there from the China, the Song Dynasty, and there are other stories which comes from the France and some from England also. But then we do not have any proper recorded document which can, you know, say concretely that yes, menu has been originated in this year or, you know, from this place. But yes, we have certain stories recorded in the history, like the history of the King Louis XV of France or the history of the Duke of Brunswick in England. If we talk about the recorded mention in the history, we have two, three such incidents. Like one of the incidents is from the France, which says that Louis XV of France used to offer the banquets or the buffets to his guests, where he used to serve the menu different courses, starters separate, the main course separate, and the dessert separately. On the other hand, we have other story which is recorded in this history or in the books is from the Duke of Brunswick, England. You know, he also used to offer the banquets for his guest, and in one of the banquets he was referring to a piece of paper, and somebody asked him that what is this piece of paper. So he replied that this is, you know, the list of dishes which are going to come from the kitchen, and it is in the same order also. So I'm trying to reserve my appetite accordingly. So these are some of the historic mentions of the origin of the menu, and both these mentions are from the 18th century, somewhere around 1740s and 1750s. This was all about the origin of the menu. Now we are going to talk about the types of menu. Although the word menu itself is French in origin, and then we have another word, bill of fare, as it is known as in England. So the menu or the bill of fare, both these are, we have a lot of variants and the styles of menus, but then broadly, or primarily, we have only two types of menus. One is the table d'hôte and another is the à la carte. Like in earlier days, we do not have these those proper menu cards and all. What we used to have in those days is we had a chalkboard, and the service personnel or the service team or somebody from the service staff, they used to present their chalkboard to the guest to make their choices. So that is why we use this word à la carte, which means from the card, right? So we have primarily two types of menus, the à la carte and the table d'hôte. Now, the table d'hôte is a fixed menu at a fixed price. Table d'hôte, you know, it literally means table of the host. Now, whenever we go to a table d'hôte restaurant, you know, we do not have much of the choices. We are only offered with what the chef has prepared for that particular day, or the owner has prepared for that particular day. So we cannot make our own choices. We have to go by the owner's or the chef's choices for that particular day. Tomorrow we may have some other dishes included into the menu, but then for that day we have to go by those dishes only. And that entire menu is having a fixed price. Table d'hôte menu is, we can say that it is a fixed menu with a fixed price. On the other hand, we have the à la carte menu, which literally says from the card or in the style of the card. Here we have number of choices from the menu. We can pick up the recipes or the dishes from the menu. We can make our own menu, prepare our own menu. And the best thing is all the dishes, each dish is individually priced. So we can order whatever we want. We do not have to choose the entire menu. We can make up our own choice and we can order them, and we have to pay them for whatever we have ordered only and not for the other things. So now if someone talks about like how we can differentiate the table d'hôte menu in the à la carte menu. So if this is the question, we can answer this, you know, we can differentiate the table d'hôte menu in the à la carte menu on various parameters on the basis of different things. I would like to start with choice. Now, on if we are going to differentiate both these menu on the basis of choice, then we can say that in tabletop menu we have got either no choice or very limited choice. On the other hand, the a la carte menu has a vast variety of choices to make from. That is one difference. Another difference we can say is price. We can differentiate both these menu on the basis of price also. Now how? The table d'hote menu is collectively priced. The entire menu is fixed and we sell this menu at a fixed price only. Whether we are consuming it fully or not, we have to pay for it. For example, if we are served with a four-course menu, that is a starter, a main course, a salad and a dessert. So whether we are consuming all these four courses or not, right? Irrespective of that fact, we have to pay for the entire menu. Now, on the other hand, we can make our own choices. We can order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever number of dishes we want to order, and we have to pay for them only. We are not going to pay for the other dishes which we haven't ordered. So this is another parameter or the base on which both these menus can be differentiated. So the one we have the choice, another we have the price. Now the third parameter on which we can categorize or differentiate these both menus can be cooking of the food or the preparation. Now in the table d'hote menu, the food is always in the fully prepared form, whereas in the a la carte menu, the food is in semi-prepared form. In table d'hote menu, we know what we are going to serve the entire day, so we can prepare all those dishes in advance, whereas we do not know what the guest is going to order in a la carte menu, so we cannot prepare them in advance. So that way the food is in semi-prepared form in a la carte menu. So this is the third parameter or the basis on which we can differentiate the table d'hote menu and the a la carte menu. Now on this very basis, that the preparation of the food, how the food is there in the kitchen, in which what condition, on this basis we can generate another differentiation, another point on which we can categorize or differentiate both these menus, and that is the waiting time. Now since the food is in fully prepared form in the table d'hote menu, the waiting time is very less. Similarly, since the food is in the semi-prepared form in the a la carte menu, the waiting time is more. So the waiting time is less in table d'hote menu and the waiting time is more for the guest. Once the guest orders the food, then he has to wait for a little longer in the a la carte and for quite a little time in table d'hote menu. So till now we have got four bases on which we have differentiated the table d'hote menu and the a la carte menu, and they have been the price, the choices, the preparation of the food and the waiting time. Now we can have a few more differences, like we can categorize both these or differentiate both these menus on the basis of the portion size also. By the way, this is very important. The portion size in the table d'hote menu is small, whereas the portion size in the a la carte menu is bigger. So this is one another basis on which we can differentiate both these menus, the portion size. I'll repeat this, the portion size is smaller in the table d'hote menu, whereas it is larger in case of the a la carte menu. We have one another difference also, the cover layout, or we can say the silver. In table d'hote menu, we have a set menu and we are going to serve that menu the entire day. So we know very well in advance that what are the dishes which we are going to serve when the guest arrives on the table. In this way, what we can do is we can lay out the cover very well, neatly, nicely in advance, because we know what are the dishes which we are going to serve, what are the courses which we are going to serve. So accordingly, we can lay out the silver or the cover very well in advance. On the other hand, a la carte is a little elaborate menu. Guest can make his own choices from those number of dishes. So we actually do not know what the guest is going to order. So we cannot lay out the cover in advance. So we have to lay out a very standard cover for the a la carte situation. So this is one more difference, wherein we can lay out the cover very well in advance in the table d'hote condition. If we are serving the table d'hote menu, we cannot lay out the entire cover, or we cannot do the entire setup on the table in case of the a la carte menu. So these are six major differences which on which you know these two menus can be differentiated. Now we've gone through the origin of the menu also and the types of menus also. There are other variants and styles of the menus also, like the carte de jour, the plat de jour, the banquet or the buffet menu, or the cyclic menu. But then these are more or less the variants or the extensions of these, either of these menus only. Like if we talk about the plat de jour, the plat de jour or plate of the day, and we also call it the dish of the day. So plat de jour is basically a special dish prepared by the chef for a particular day. So that is fixed. Similarly, we have the carte de jour. Carte de jour is the card of the day. It is again an extension of the normal menu which is there in the restaurant, a very small menu prepared specifically for a particular day. It may be some occasion, and that is why the chef has prepared a special menu, a small menu which may consist of maybe a starter or one dish from the main course or maybe a dessert. I can give you an example of carte de jour in the Indian context also. Like there are a lot of hotels which do serve this carte de jour, especially when we have those Navratra days, right? So hotel used to serve some special dishes when the Navratras are going on, right? Then we have the banquet menu or the buffet menu. Again, these are the set menus for the, we sell them at a set prices. And another example is the cyclic menu. So the cyclic menu is more kind of prevalent in the, hostel mess or the college canteens. So what is cyclic menu is? We have a set menu for a particular day like Monday, another set menu for Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and so on. And the menu itself, repeat itself on Monday. So we, this cycle goes on for, depends on the organization, for a month also, for 2 months also, and for quarterly also. And then again, we change the menu, right? So this way, it is known as the cyclic menu. But then these all menus are the fixed menus and sold for a fixed price. So that is why we can say that all these menus, whether it is the plat de jour or the carte de jour, or the banquet menu, or buffet menu, or the cyclic menu. All these menus are the extension of the table d'hote menu only. Because we know now that table d'hote menu is a set menu, a fixed menu, which we sell at a fixed price. So now, you might be able to, by now, differentiate the table d'hote menu and the a la carte menu very nicely. This is all for today, but then stay tuned with me for my next video. Because in the next video, we are going to discuss something very interesting, and that is the French classical menu. Thank you all for watching this video, and if you like the video and the content and the information, please do like and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon for the further notifications of my videos. Thank you guys, thank you so much.